saw a bright light to the northwest, which he thought was unusual.
One thing is clear to Father Gill. It isn't Venus.
In fact, he saw Venus to its left. He thought that perhaps it had to be a plane.
But it doesn't act like any conventional plane.
The objects seem to be completely silent.
As it came down closer, they could see it was shining like a halo of light on the underside of the clouds.
It's when I saw it before.
And then, the mysterious object disappears. Father Gill heads back to the mission house.
Evening, Father.
To record what he saw.
He was certain that he saw something, but he was sufficiently kind of careful about his observations that he wasn't going to draw any real conclusions about it until he was absolutely certain.
He is soon joined by one of his assistants, Annie Laurie Baroa.
Good evening, Father.
Good evening, Annie.
Annie Laurie was an assistant school teacher at the local mission.
6:45, bright white light sighted amidst.
Father, do you see that?
This time, the sighting is much closer.
It was about 500 feet away. There was this one main object. But there was also smaller satellite objects seen in close proximity.
What is it, Father?
Possibly satellites?
Satellites had been launched around the Earth 2 years before this.
We had the Sputnik launches, so that was the only kind of reference point that people had. As this thing approached,
they see a figure on the craft.
That's no satellite.
It was getting closer to them.
The objects moved away, then shot across the bay. It was also witnessed by others. There were approximately about 25 witnesses.
The following evening, Father Gill writes a report to his superiors. Still convinced there's a logical explanation for what he saw the night before.
Father!
But any rational explanation is about to be put to the test.
Father! It's back.
Where?
At the beach.
On the beach, Stephen Moy and others have already gathered.
They started watching what appeared to be the same object back again.
Including the same mysterious shape on top. And it's not alone.
There were four figures on the top of the craft that were visible to the everybody below, essentially.
These figures were fairly large.
Who are they?
It could be military.
Father Gill was still entertaining the possibility that maybe it was some sort of exotic or advanced aircraft from the Americans.
Is that really military? Possibly.
It wasn't that long after World War II when this occurred, and so America had a large presence in the Pacific. Father Gill decided to initiate communication. One of the figures moved over to the edge.
It was at that point that something very extraordinary happened. One of the figures waved back. Their intention was to perhaps try and encourage it to land. And then they'd really be clear-cut what they were dealing with there.
And then the craft moves out of view towards the mission house.
Everyone, back to the mission house. Let's go.
Back at the compound, 100 meters from the mission house.
Wow. Oh, my God.
The ship hovers silently, as if waiting for further contact.
What is that? Father Gill tried an additional experiment.
The object then slowly began to move back and forth in a pendulum-like fashion.
It was just purely imitating the motion or the movement of the flashlight backwards and forwards.
And then the show comes to a stop.
The object sort of slowly moved off into the cloud cover.
All right, everyone back inside.
It seemed to me with the many discussions I had with Father Gill over the decades that from his own religious beliefs, maybe this was like an angelic kind of experience.
In total, 25 witnesses signed Father Gill's report on the strange sightings of June 26th and 27th, 1959. 6 months after the event, Air Force personnel interview Father Gill and attribute what he saw to a celestial phenomenon, the planet Venus. Noted UFO debunker Dr. Donald Menzel agrees, adding that Father Gill is known to be nearsighted. But that argument doesn't explain the other 25 witnesses. The 1959 sightings in New Guinea lead to the first credible witness report of extraterrestrials in UFO history.